GE stock is up in the pre-market. First quarter profits exceeded analyst estimates. CEO Jeff Immelt saying that losses have peaked in the GE Capital unit. For more, we are joined right now over the phone by Sanford C. Bernstein analyst Steve Winoker. He is voted best independent analyst and best up-and-comer by institutional investors. Steve, thank you so much for joining us early on this Friday morning. Glad to have you with us. GE Capital, we just highlighted, it's a strong part of the company's results. Everybody I talk to want to know, to what extent is GE gaming the figures for GE Capital?
Well, good morning, Deirdre. I think it's a fair question, particularly in light of so many quarters of restatements and reclassifications and earnings that were positive after tax but not before tax. This quarter is probably the cleanest quarter I think I've seen since covering the company. There are certainly issues that we will get more clarity about on the call that takes place in about 35 minutes. But right now, judging from the press release and statements that we could see put out, it looks reasonably clean. They actually made money in GE Capital pre-tax, which was, I think, probably a bigger surprise. They did that by lowering, they had lower provisions than I know we expected, and had performed better in some of the business units, such as commercial real estate also, which even though it's a big loss, it was a lower loss than we had expected. But overall, back to your question, it is a it's a pretty clean quarter, and we're looking forward to getting more details from the company.
So, Steve, you mentioned, you know, the loan losses being lower as one, not necessarily a surprise, but one standout point to you. What else caught your attention?
Well, on the industrial side of the business, revenues were light by our numbers, about 2.5%. Keep in mind, they earned 21 cents. About 16 cents of that was from their industrial businesses and 5 cents from their capital businesses. We had 17 cents out there on the street, of which 16 cents was industrial and 1 cent was capital. So that 16 cent number was the same on industrial. They got there basically by having a lower expenses in their corporate line. The rest of the businesses, other than corporate, if you exclude corporate, were actually light our earnings number by about 9% and our revenue number by 2.5%. So we're going to want to understand that a little bit better. And then on the capital side, they clearly beat our number, and it was a function, as I mentioned, of lower provisioning. Real estate was a little bit less bad than we thought. The vertical businesses, GECAS, EFS, all outperformed our expectations.
Steve? Yep. Steve, I just want to jump in here and ask you a question about orders. How is it that GE can report an 8% decline in orders in an economy, a world economy that's growing, that's rebounding, and so many of the businesses that GE supplies are beginning to restock after drawing down big inventories?
Well, it's a good point. Their orders are in businesses, remember, that are large, heavy, tend to be late cycle businesses, power generation, aircraft engines, et cetera, and healthcare equipment. And a lot of these different businesses tend to recover a little bit later in this cycle on an equipment basis than other parts of the economy. And so that's what I think, as people would expect. The important thing is to start to see those orders get less bad.
Okay.
And I think that is what we're seeing.
Steve, we thank you so much for your time.
Thanks.
Steve Winoker from Sanford C. Bernstein.